Kesedaran konsep halal semakin mendapat pengiktirafan yang meluas. Industri halal bernilai $3.1 trilion dolar Amerika pada tahun 2018. Dianggarkan melonjak ke $5 trilion dolar Amerika pada tahun 2030. Oleh itu, pematuhan kepada pensijilan halal adalah pemangkin kepada kemajuan industri halal. Jadi, bagaimana caranya anda boleh mendapat pensijilan halal? Skim pensijilan halal kini meliputi skop yang lebih luas selain daripada barangan makanan hinggalah ke industri farmaseutikal, kosmetik dan penjagaan diri, logistik dan banyak lagi. Program digital e-rehal dari Halal Development Corporation (HDC) merupakan titik permulaan. E-rehal merupakan wadah untuk mengakses kesediaan dalam talian. Ia merupakan sebuah platform e-pembelajaran interaktif yang dirangka khusus untuk memberi pemahaman di samping menilai kesediaan dalam pematuhan syarat pensijilan halal. E-rehal mempunyai ciri-ciri yang asas, fleksibel dan boleh diakses pada bila-bila masa, di mana sahaja. E-rehal adalah satu platform e-bimbingan khusus untuk syarikat peniagaan tempatan memahami dan menilai kesediaan keperluan pematuhan pensijilan halal melalui 5 modul dan 1 kuis akhir seperti berikut. Asas halal dan haram, manual prosedur pensijilan halal, MS 1500-2019, pelaksanaan audit halal dan navigasi My E-Halal. Terbuka kepada skim terpilih, e-rehal akan membuka laluan bagi pasaran halal domestik dan antarabangsa. Untuk keterangan lanjut, layari hkc.hdcglobal.com hari ini. E-rehal menilai persediaan anda ke arah pensijilan halal. Being halal certified carries value-added advantages. It creates more demand and opportunities in the local and global market. But what comes next? What does that mean to you? How can you gain market access? At Halal Development Corporation, HDC, we offer you e-learning through eRemark. eRemark is a digital platform to evaluate your market readiness. It is an interactive online program that guides and coaches you to penetrate into local and international hypermarkets in Malaysia, like Aeon, Maidin, Giant, and others. Being online means it's flexible and can be completed at your own pace from anywhere. eRemark encompasses the following topics, completing with a final quiz. They are Trade Description Act 2011, barcode, grading, packaging and labeling, general food labeling guidelines, logistics and retailing, understanding local and foreign hypermarkets in Malaysia, and product category and procedural basics. eRemark will impart crucial knowledge and information to enable you to make a detailed self-examination of your current standing and what is needed to be done. So, go ahead and sign up for eRemark today. For more information, log on to hkc.hdcglobal.com. Malaysia has become a benchmark in the global halal arena. As this is in tandem with the country's vision, there will be a need for a larger pool of professionals, experts, and skilled workers to meet the demand of the global halal industry. Halal Talent Tour is a program initiated by the Halal Development Corporation, HDC, to enhance human capital development and create awareness for occupational growth in the halal industry. In collaboration with Jabatan Pembangunan Kemahiran, Halal Talent Tour consists of Career Talks, an overview of Halal Occupational Framework, OF, a reference to identify structured career paths in halal industry. Industry Tips, to gain perspectives and prosper in the halal industry through sharing sessions by industry experts and related agencies. And Portfolio Development, a workshop on recognition of prior achievements or Pengiktirafan Pencapaian Terdahulu, PPT, a program to award Malaysian Skill Certificate, MSC, or Sijil Kemahiran Malaysia, SKM, to employees who have demonstrated skills outlined in NOS. Halal Talent Tour reveals various opportunities for career advancement while enabling participants to leverage on technical and vocational education and training, or TVET, and other skills training platforms related to the halal industry. In addition, it also guides participants to become qualified as halal skilled workers through the Malaysian Skills Certificate, MSC. Join us. Vast career opportunities await you. For more information, log on to hdcglobal.com. Halal Talent Tour, to discover your potential today. In today's commercial landscape, acquiring information is priceless. That's because data and market intelligence are crucial to determine potential opportunities and direction. More importantly, in the halal market, where growth has been robust. Halal Development Corporation, HDC, presents Halal Knowledge Center, or HKC 2.0, for halal-related fraternities. HKC is an empowering IT-based tool for sustainable development of halal knowledge. HKC encompasses digital library, interactive dashboard, infographics, halal community of practice, and many more. HKC features knowledge management trends in market intelligence, emerging sectors, and impact studies, as well as economic indicators for halal practitioners and thought leaders. It possesses a repository of 25,000 physical and digital references, database with over 2 million records, and more than 1,000 scenario analysis reports. By interfacing with HDC's big data resources, users have an unparalleled avenue for information and knowledge. This makes it a paramount authority in halal knowledge management. HKC gives you the edge to stay ahead of the market. Sign up at hkc.hdcglobal.com today. Halal Knowledge Center, the new frontier in halal intelligence. Explore a new world in halal knowledge. In the era of seamless global commerce, new networks and markets are cultivated almost instantly. The emergence of IR 4.0 has prompted us towards big data analytics, Internet of Things, and digitizing initiatives. Realizing this, it's crucial you don't miss out on anything. Having that in mind, Halal Development Corporation, HDC, has developed Digital Augmented Showcase of Halal Malaysia, Dash. Dash offers an integrated digital platform which delivers a combination of augmented reality and interactive enabled presentations of products and services to the market. And what's unique about Dash is that it can be mobilized to any location, domestically and internationally. In addition to more avenues for creative display through 2D and 3D visual superiority, Dash offers exposure at multiple platforms to various global events. Being interactive and possessing vibrant dynamicism, Dash adds clearer perspective to the impression you make without your physical presence. Now that's something that will keep you accessible while being cost-effective at the same time. So choose an extensive customer experience by signing on with Dash today. For more information, log on to hdcglobal.com. Stay global, be digitized, get Dash.
HDC continues to aim for the highest in realizing the full potential of Malaysia's halal industry. Halal Sourcing Partnership creates opportunities and facilitates the onboarding of halal industry players to connect their products with multinational companies with the objective to grow their businesses.
We welcome all halal industry players to join this program and realize your true potential. Be part of halal ecosystem community and turn aspiration into reality.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021. Thank you for attending this virtual event brought to you by Halal Development Corporation, HDC. While we're waiting for the rest of the invitees to log on, make yourself comfortable while sipping and enjoying your coffee. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021. Thank you for attending this virtual event brought to you by Halal Development Corporation, HDC. While we're waiting for the rest of the invitees to log on, make yourself comfortable while sipping and enjoying your coffee. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021. Thank you for attending this virtual event brought to you by Halal Development Corporation, HDC. While we're waiting for the rest of the invitees to log on, make yourself comfortable while sipping and enjoying your coffee. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021. Thank you for attending this virtual event brought to you by Halal Development Corporation, HDC. While we're waiting for the rest of the invitees to log on, make yourself comfortable while sipping and enjoying.
Halal industry is fast becoming one of the most important business segments in the global landscape. For Malaysia, the development of the halal industry has remained one of the major focus areas since the 1980s. The establishment of Halal Development Corporation, or HDC, is an embodiment of Malaysia's commitment to scaling the promising potential of the halal industry in accelerating economic impact and elevating Malaysia as the global halal hub.
HDC was entrusted to be the leader to take the halal industry in Malaysia one step up. HDC has been mandated now to actually increase the number of halal players.
As a secretariat of the Malaysia Halal Development Council, we act as a central coordinating agency on all matters regarding halal ecosystem development in Malaysia.
Since the conception of the company in 2006, we have taken on the mantle of central coordinator, shouldering the responsibility of facilitating the entry of industry players into the halal economy through our services and offerings. With 21 halal parks, we are the proud host of the largest halal hub in the world.
In HDC, we promote investment into halal parks and we facilitate business growth of the companies operating within our halal parks.
Now HDC has created services and facilities for these people in the halal park to grow. You are able to get the full service where the whole ecosystem of halal can support you.
We aim to attract more investors and industry players through these unique offerings that will provide business ventures with a competitive edge. Human capital development is the key catalyst and strategic driver in ensuring the sustainability of the halal industry. With this in mind, we develop halal professionals with the essential knowledge and skills to push the envelope in raising the standards of the halal industry in Malaysia.
HDC will train halal knowledge personnel and groom them to become halal industry experts. These industry experts will serve the halal supply chain worldwide.
The halal market has expanded beyond the food sector in serving both Muslim as well as non-Muslim consumers. Our experts is dedicated to providing advisory services for potential businesses to better understand the halal landscape and meeting the requirements of the halal standards.
As your trusted partner in halal businesses, we facilitate potential companies in getting halal certificate. But moving forward, we are also offering our services to any country and government who are interested to develop their own halal ecosystem.
In enhancing the potential of the market, we leverage digital technology in establishing a one-stop center that aims to bridge the gap between businesses and industry by providing access to global halal players.
The Halal Integrated Platform is going to be our big project. It is a virtual ecosystem network that will connect industry players and stakeholders within the halal ecosystem that will create business opportunities such as trade, investment, information sharing, technology transfer that will benefit the halal industry globally as a whole.
I see HDC to be to go global, creating market opportunities for Malaysian companies to export. And this is the key role of HDC.
HDC aspires to become a world-class organization. We want to build a Malaysia as the most competitive country in the global halal industry, and this is going to be a very exciting journey for all of us. Be part of our halal community. Trust HDC.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good morning to distinguished guest Yang Berbahagia Datuk Sri Dr. Muhammad Uzir Mahidin, Chief Statistician Department of Statistics Malaysia DOSM, Yang Berusaha Encik Hairul Arifin Sahari, Chief Executive Officer Halal Development Corporation HDC, Our distinguished guest, Brigadier General Dato' Dr. A. Halim Haji Basari, Director of Pharmacy, MAFHS, Health Services Division, Ministry of Defense. Yang Berusaha Tuan Haji Muhammad Roslan bin Muhammad Saluddin, Halal Advisor to the Malaysian Islamic Chamber of Commerce, representatives from government and private sectors, members of the media, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the organizing committee, we'd like to take this moment to welcome all of you to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021, brought to you by Halal Development Corporation, or HDC. This event is conducted virtually, of course, in keeping with the new norm and the call by the government to minimize large gatherings as the nation works together to curb the spread of the coronavirus. I'm Raymond Goh, and I'm your Master of Ceremony for today's program. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, let me start off first by setting the context and purpose of this particular event. Now, the objective today is to provide an overview on HDC's strategic direction of the overall halal industry and sectoral roadmap, with the aim, of course, to promote a common understanding amongst key stakeholders, both from the public sector and the private sector, on all the initiatives outlined in the freshly crafted Halal Industry and Sectoral Roadmap 2021, specifically towards pharmaceuticals and the food services sector. Alhamdulillah, we have an excellent participation from various ministries, government agencies, and from private entities. The organizers and I humbly hope that you will find the program that we've lined up today to be both engaging, useful, and beneficial. HDC is committed to facilitate the implementation of the sectoral roadmaps initiatives with identified stakeholders. This is imperative for the potential of the growth of the halal industry to be realized for the benefit of all. Now, before we go into the next segment of our program, first and foremost, in order for today's event to be blessed, I would like to take this moment to invite Encik Hanafi to lead us all in a short prayer or dua.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. We express our gratitude to you for allowing us to attend the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation 2021, Seizing Opportunities in Halal Industry for Pharmaceuticals and Food Services on this auspicious day. Give us your endless blessings for our ceremony today. We humbly pray to you, Ya Allah, the Almighty, that we will be able to exhibit the strategic plans and implementation of the two halal sectoral roadmaps, namely pharmaceuticals and food services, in this event. We hope that this initiative will help us to position Malaysia as the most competitive country in the global halal industry. Ya Allah, we ask you for the safety of our religion. Kindly give us strength and courage to face and the struggle to find and gain knowledge. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, you are the one exalted in power, the one full of knowledge, between the good and evils, between the obvious and the unseen. Protect us from calamity and danger, from disturbance and strife. Grant us our prayers. Guide us to righteousness and to the path that you bless. Provide us with people that are sincere, trustworthy, noble and honest, responsible in building a developed nation, building a united people. We forever seek your blessings towards excellence, glory and distinction. Ya Allah, may our gathering here a blessed one, and our dispersion thereafter a guided and protected one, and make easy for us every difficult thing. With you special and kindness, for it is easy for you to make every difficult thing easy. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina azabannar. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Thank you very much, Encik Hanafi, for leading us in the dua. May this meaningful event be blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. Now, to kick off this event, it gives me great pleasure to invite HDC's esteemed Chief Executive Officer, Encik Hairul Arifin Sahari, to say a few words in his welcome address to actually welcome each and every one of you to today's very meaningful program. Ladies and gentlemen, Encik Hairul.
Yang berbahagia, Datuk Seri Dr. Muhammad Uzir Mahidin, Chief Statistician Malaysia, Department of Statistics Malaysia. Brigadier General Datuk Dr. A. Halim Haji Basri, Director of Pharmacy Health Services Division, Ministry of Defence Malaysia. Yang Berusaha Tuan Haji Muhammad Roslan bin Muhammad Saludin, Halal Advisor Dewan Perdagangan Islam Malaysia. Distinguished guests, members of media, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to be here this morning to welcome all of you to the Halal Sectoral Roadmap Implementation today, organized by the Halal Development Corporation. As we are aware that the first few months of 2021 has been difficult due to amidst lockdown and battling COVID-19 pandemic, nevertheless, we will continue to embrace the new norm for a stronger future economic recovery, inshallah. I am pleased to share that HDC has put in place Halal Sectoral Roadmaps to strengthen the Halal National Blueprint based on current global economic scenario. I hope the Halal Industry Roadmap in two sectors, which are pharmaceuticals and food services, will achieve our objective to obtain buy-in, acceptance and feedback from public and private stakeholders representing business communities, educators and consumers alike. This initiative is certainly appropriate in view of the current global economic outlook and increasing demand for high-value halal products and services. It is also reaffirms HDC commitment to increase halal industry economic returns, focusing on our niche areas within the halal promoter sectors. Ladies and gentlemen, with 1.8 billion Muslims, around one quarter of the world's population, there is a substantial potential to grow halal economy. As we are fully aware that the halal industry has grown by $3.1 trillion in 2018 and is expected to grow to $5 trillion by 2030. According to Reuters, the halal food industry alone is worth $1.6 trillion, while the halal cosmetic industry and halal pharmaceuticals industry are both worth some $39 billion and $97 billion respectively. Locally, it is estimated that both halal sectors will record a positive growth of 18% CAGR for food services and 4.2% CAGR for pharmaceuticals by 2025. Food services expected to record revenue of minimum RM40 billion and pharmaceutical to record revenue of RM1.6 billion and total employment expected will be more than 112,000 cumulatively. Total exports of RM440 million and private investment of RM550 million by 2025 for both sectors. I am confident that Malaysia will be the leading contributor to global consumers' consumption on halal food products. Ladies and gentlemen, in line with HDC vision to make halal the first choice in business ventures and its mission of providing solutions for businesses to excel in the halal market space, strengthened by the placement of HDC under the MITI, demonstrates the commitment by the government to advance Malaysia's halal industry not only through industrial development, but through greater investment and expansion into international markets. We have achieved significant milestones thus far in developing this industry, and many countries have recognized Malaysia's leadership in the global halal industry. As to date, we have recorded a total investment of RM16 billion, export value of RM40 billion a year in average, and 350,000 employment in total. Ladies and gentlemen, realizing the importance of halal sectoral growth and demand globally, not only from OIC countries, but also emerging countries and continents, HDC has identified 11 key sectors to grow. Among others, food services and pharmaceuticals, halal ingredients, halal medical tourism, halal cosmetics, halal logistics, and halal modest fashion. For an inclusive and holistic approach in growing the industry, the private and public sector stakeholders are engaged for consultative input. More than 70 stakeholders in food services and pharmaceuticals have been identified to two strategic workshops between August and October last year to give valuable inputs, including challenges and interventions required. Through a clear context on the challenges faced, targeted interventions are developed to help addressing them, followed by detailed action plan on how the interventions are to be delivered with milestones and potential owners. In food services, 6 halal key results area with 7 initiatives and 17 interventions have been identified to address 6 issues surrounding this sector. Whereas in pharmaceuticals, 4 halal key result area with 6 initiatives and 21 interventions have been identified to address 5 issues surrounding the sector. Upon completion of the roadmap development, we have established implementation working committee, namely the sectoral working group for pharmaceuticals and food services. This working group comprises of experts in halal industry and will play as advisory roles in making sure the rollout of all high impact initiatives progressing until 2025. Issues and roadblocks will be resolved within the sectoral working group, and escalation to the highest level of Majlis Pembangunan Industri Halal will take place as part of implementation governance. Implementation will also involve coordination between relevant ministries and agencies. Inshallah, with solid roadmap and implementation governance in place, our target to achieve 40 billion ringgit revenue billion revenue generated by halal food services and RM 1.6 billion revenue generated by halal pharmaceuticals will be materialized by 2025. Ladies and gentlemen, HDC will in the near future unveil strategic and high impact initiatives that have been identified in both sectors at the Halal Industry Showcase. The showcase presents huge potential and provides a summary view of Malaysia's halal economy landscape through its sectoral development approach. The information sharing will cover the halal industry key strategies, the key sector focus, as well as opportunities for Malaysia to capture the global halal market. The purpose of the Malaysia Halal Industry Showcase is to provide an up-to-date overview of Malaysia's halal industry, sharing its key implementation strategies, its sectoral development approach to business leaders, entrepreneurs, government officials, and industry bodies to inspire greater participation in the global halal economy for the good of all. Ladies and gentlemen, before my closing, I am proud to share a very significant milestone in the Malaysia halal industry where HDC collaboration with DOSM will be working towards the production of Malaysia's halal industry statistical data analysis and sharing. The first in the world verified of halal big data backed by the government to pave the way for more precise economic indicator census for halal industry. My deepest gratitude to Datuk Seri Dr. Muhammad Uzair and his team for being present today. Applaud DOSM collaborating effort with HDC. Thank you to all distinguished panelists for your thought leader insights today. For your enthusiasm and commitment certainly augurs well for the future of Malaysia's halal agenda and the global halal industry. I hope all present and online viewers will benefit knowledge insights at today's webinar series, Seizing Opportunities in Halal Industry for Pharmaceutical and Food Services. Thank you. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Encik Hairul, for that inspiring welcome address. Now, I'm sure all the stakeholders, particularly from the private sector, are keen to lend support or further collaborate with HDC, as well as other ministries and agencies, to grow the industry. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to draw your attention to this energizing trailer produced by HDC to showcase opportunities in the halal industry.
With an estimated 1.8 billion Muslim population, which equals to 25% of the world's population, there is a substantial potential to grow the halal economies. The global halal economy is a $3.1 trillion market in 2018 and forecasted to reach $5 trillion by 2025. Halal market is traditionally driven by OIC countries. However, other continents are showing an increase in halal demand products and services, such as the African region, Americas, Far East, and Europe. Halal economies have contributed significantly to Malaysia's socio-economic development. From 2010 to 2020, more than 360 billion ringgit in halal export have been recorded. The accumulated investment from 2010 to 2020 is worth more than 16 billion ringgit. An agency under the Ministry of International Trade and Industry, or MITIC, HDC is the world's first government-backed halal industry development corporation. We play a catalytic role as a facilitator to improve governance mechanisms, creating new and bigger market spaces, fostering industry competitiveness and empowering thought leadership across the halal ecosystem. It will contribute to the overall socio-economic development, including increasing investment, trade expansion, strengthening halal integrity, and creating jobs. In addition, HDC also provides value-added solutions for business to excel in the halal market, including Halal Park, Halal Integrated Platform, Halal Consultancy, and Halal Training. With an increased demand for halal products and services globally, more halal sectors have emerged beyond food and beverages, including medical devices, medical tourism, cosmetics and personal care, logistics, and six other promoted sectors. In 2020, two halal sectorial maps have been developed. The Halal Sectorial Roadmap will provide clarity for the industry, ready to land to 1,000 feet from 30,000 feet. To move forward with specific intervention to address challenges.
Wow, there you have it. Such vast potential of the halal industry globally. $3.1 trillion in 2018 alone, with the potential of growing to $5 trillion by the year 2025. Now, you might be wondering how we can have the private sector really participate and benefit in terms of growing their businesses, including, of course, yours and your stakeholders. Well, next is a panelist session which will discuss specifically on this. And this is between the public sector representatives, Encik Hani Sofian Alias from HDC, expert in halal pharmaceuticals, Brigadier General Dato' Dr. A. Halim Haji Basari, an expert in halal food services, Tuan Haji Muhammad Roslan Muhammad Saluddin. Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin with our panel session, Seizing Opportunities in Pharmaceuticals and Food Services. Right, so for our panel discussion for this time around, we certainly hope to delve deeper into the sectoral roadmaps that have been established in order to grow the halal economies. And we certainly hope, of course, with the input from our very distinguished panel of speakers joining us here today, to give us a deeper insight into those. Now, pharmaceutical and the food services sector have been chosen particularly because for pharmaceutical, as many of us know, that we're in a current health condition faced by the world with the surge of the pandemic that's affecting billions of people of the population around the world. And also for the food services sector, it's currently experiencing an exponential growth with the delivery systems provided in this sector. So two particular sectors that we're covering. And of course, with every roadmap and initiative, there are challenges, and we shall be discussing with our panel the initiatives to address all these challenges and, of course, to overcome them. I'd like to bring in our first speaker, which is Hani Sofian. Perhaps you can share with us in broad strokes the current landscape of the halal industry, both locally in Malaysia and, of course, internationally.
Thank you, Mr. Raymond. So, demand for halal is expected to grow exponentially. In 2018, the halal market was at $1.3 trillion. And by 2025, we expect to see the figure reach about $5 trillion. Of course, this demand is driven by the 1.8 billion Muslim populations. And we are seeing also the new trend, the new acceptance interest from the non-Muslim majority countries as well, especially in the Europe, Africa, and the North America. But the big question right now, people are still asking us, while we are saying that this demand is big, how is it now due to the pandemic and pandemic situations? But you see, even before pandemic, we have challenges. Global economy is not as smooth as we expected. 2018, our export was affected poorly by the fact that palm oil price went down. In addition to that, we know that the US-China trade war in 2018, even Brexit have some impact to our global economy as well. And having said that, halal at that point shift focus into another new sectors that we are talking. Initially, it was more of processed foods, commodity products. But in 2019, we start hearing about Muslim-friendly tourism. It's also part of halal industry sectors. We all know about the interest of having interventions or getting opportunities from the Tokyo Olympic 2020. So again, halal industry rise again. And locally, we are seeing also the same thing after the pandemic hit Malaysia. We see that food service sectors is, what do you call that, increasing or growing very fast. In fact, the food service, we are expecting about 11.7 annual growth from now. And this is driven by the fact that more and more people are actually looking at food delivery systems to get their, what do you call that, consumable and so on. And we expect that by 2025, halal food service alone in Malaysia will reach about 200 billion, what do you call that, worth of market price.
Excellent. And those numbers are rather tremendous numbers. Yes. Hani Sofian, perhaps you can give us an insight into how HDC is spearheading the growth of the halal industry.
Okay. Let me start by saying that Malaysia first, before we speak about HDC, because Malaysia is well known in terms of pioneering the halal industry development. Of course, this one thanks to our strengths in halal certifications, and also our standards development. So hence, HDC was established in 2006 to actually look into the opportunities and potential growth areas in terms of the halal industry itself. So we established the Halal Industry Master Plan. It's a national blueprint that actually outlines the strategies that we need to take in terms of developing the halal industry. So we need to see how halal, apart from protecting the integrity, also contributes in terms of socio-economy using the halal ecosystem model. So we look into halal integrity, we look into increasing productions, we look into increasing investments, employment, and of course trade. But we know that halal is not just about food. So in order to develop the halal industry effectively, we need to look at the specific interventions on each sectors that we are looking at. So within these different sectors, we will identify different type of opportunities, and they're also facing different type of challenges. Hence, the roadmap is there. So these roadmaps will look into how do we translate the 30,000 feet strategies that we have in the master plan into a 1,000 feet execution level, so that this can help our, not just the overall companies, but especially the SMEs in Malaysia, to actually be part of this the global halal industry.
Right, we're having certainly a long-term plan, perhaps over the next 5 years. Can you just share with us which are the key sectors that HDC is targeting for growth?
Okay, Raymond. HDC, together with our key stakeholders, have identified 11 sectors. They are the food and beverage sectors, of course, this is very particular in Halal, pharmaceuticals, ingredients, cosmetic and personal care. Now we are looking into modest fashion as well, medical tourism, medical devices, Muslim-friendly hospitality, logistic services, Islamic finance, and but last not to forget, the consumer goods itself. So these are the 11 sectors that we are looking into for the next 5 years.
That's great. So we've seen many initiatives that have been set up by HDC for the growth of the halal industry, both locally and internationally. Now, with any initiative, there's bound to be challenges. I'd like to bring in Dato' Halim to share with us, perhaps on the pharmaceutical sector, what are the challenges being faced by this sector?
Thank you, Raymond. On behalf of the pharmaceutical industry, pharma in short, we would like to thank HDC for getting the private sector to provide our insights on issues and challenges on the National Halal Pharmaceutical Development Roadmap. There are five key challenges: inconsistencies, ingredients, investment in capital and certification, and economics. Let me explain, and let me be honest. We are not here to undermine any agencies or any ministries. Firstly, are the inconsistencies of halal audit and status of ingredients. Second, lack of halal ingredients availability and a database. Third, high capital outlay for facilities. Fourth, high certification costs and maintenance. And lastly, our industries lack the economies of scale. For example, inconsistencies in halal certification result in confusion for businesses. Pharma is a very technical sector. While Malaysia is the pioneer of Malaysian Standard 2424-2019, which is the halal pharmaceutical guidelines, which, by the way, give us huge advantage over all nations in the world, but the scientific interpretation of halal ingredients and recognition is missing, resulting in inconsistencies during halal audits and causes confusion and uncertainty for businesses. We need halal pharmacopoeia and a scientific advisory committee. Another example is the industry's lack of economies of scale. As halal pharmaceuticals, the logo can be only be stamped for the OTC supplements and traditional products, not on prescription medicines in Malaysia yet, and many of the export markets do not require halal certification, the market demand is insufficient to justify local production of finished products. What more, raw materials. Does company rely on importing? We import 80% of our finished product and almost 100% of raw materials. So it's challenging to sustain, especially in emergency like now. Final example, the demand in Malaysia is still mainly driven by the public health system. With private and export markets quite small, this main demand is also exacerbated by import from the multinational corporations, which have their manufacturing plants overseas and are not required to have halal certification. So this is further complicated by the fact that MOH does not require the product to be certified for procurement. Only the Minister of Defense does. Thus, the multinational corporation's view of halal certification only as an additional burden and have no incentive to seek certification. These are among the key issues that were highlighted by the industries during the roadmap workshops.
Thank you very much, Dato' Halim. Now, Haji Roslan, I'm sure in the food services sector, you too face some challenges. Perhaps you can also give us an insight of what you've seen and what you've experienced.
Well, I agree with you. Thank you, Raymond. When you talk about food, it's not just my concern, it's just those the industry's concern, it's also the concern of every one of us, because food is essential for living and we need to be, you know, having food. In fact, every morning we have to take breakfast. So this is the issues, these are things that we cannot avoid when we talk about food. And when we talk about food also, we cannot run away from discussing about what composed of food, what is required when you want to produce food. So one of the important areas of food is to have the ingredients ready to be converted into food. This is an issue when you talk about large scale production, when you talk about manufacturing, when you talk about the manufacture of food, when you talk about the export of food, yeah. And more so if you are talking about local food production, you are talking about also ingredients sometimes that is not available in Malaysia. We talk about imports. So when we talk about imports, then there are also huge challenges that we need to overcome, especially when you talk about halal food. Yeah, because halal food, you can easily address it when it is from sourced from local. But when you talk about sourcing it from elsewhere, from all around the world, then businesses especially look into the cost aspect of producing those products for that particular specialized requirement of halal. So that is an issue that we need to see. And unless this is addressed, we cannot remain in the upfront in terms of food exporting countries. So unless we can address the source by way of getting an effective database or a network of sources that we can get our supplies, yeah. The example of halal, for food products to be halal for consumption, there is need to ensure the food is halal throughout the food supply chain. It has to be from farm to fork. It has to be from end to end. So that requires a lot of work in terms of identifying and then getting it through the supply chain. And then, of course, when it comes to our shores, we need to also address the issue of the integrity of those that is coming into our. There are recent examples of this being out of control. Yeah, of course, the recent meat cartel issue that we have been facing. Yeah, so these are some of the challenges. Again, just another example of the challenges that we are facing in terms of the food sector. The new trend of food delivery services, for example, which is booming when, you know, especially when the pandemic, yeah, came to our country. So we need to look at halal not just to address existing issues, but forthcoming issues that we are faced with. Yeah, so these are some of the challenges, and there are other challenges. Yeah, the incomplete or non-availability standards. Just for example, just now we talk about food delivery services. We talk about standard operating procedures, which are not consistent, which are not uniform. Yeah, it differs from one player to another. Yeah, the absence of and lack of synchronized, harmonious, seamless import-export framework, and end-to-end in the supply chain. And then, of course, again, we are faced with the long problem of low awareness or awareness for the requirement of halal certification. People don't go for halal certification unless they understood how it can be related to their business growth.
All right, thank you very much, Haji Roslan. Now, these are some of the challenges faced by both these two sectors. And of course, we know that HDC is initiating many roadmaps and including, of course, some of the designs to challenge, to overcome these challenges. Perhaps you can, Hani Sofian, you can share with us some of the roadmaps. And I know you've been working with many agencies and stakeholders for these roadmaps. How many roadmaps are we looking at, and what's the potential outcome, and how soon can we see the results?
Okay, thank you. We heard about the challenges that the industry is facing. Remember, Dato' Alim was saying about pharmaceutical, Tuan Haji Roslan was talking about the food services. So this time, the roadmaps, we have so far developed two out of the 11 sectors that I mentioned earlier, the food services and the pharmaceutical sectors. So because of the challenges highlighted just now, we can see that it requires a lot of involvement from both public and also private sectors. So this roadmap, we take an approach where we gather all these people. It's a collaborative approach and consultative approach for us to actually address the challenges that are facing by the industry players in both sectors. But not only that, we also identify what are the new opportunities within the sectors, and how can the government, especially because HDC is an agency of the government, helps the industry to grow. So as a result, from the two roadmaps, we have identified 10 key result areas. So these key result areas will outline the three most important, output from the roadmaps, which is the first one. We look into the opportunities. So opportunities, in total, we have about 13 high impact initiatives that we are going to look into from both sectors. In terms of challenges, there are 11 key issues that we need to address. But most importantly, because some of these issues are not new, they are, you know, some of the issues has been discussed for quite some time. So most importantly, it's about the interventions from the governments. So there are about, if I'm not mistaken, about 38 interventions. And these interventions, we look in terms of how do we improve the policies, how do we improve the infrastructure, how do we have a better incentive to grow the industries, and last but not least, in terms of resources, especially the talent that is critical in terms of developing these industries. So I think this is very important. And for example, in one of the discussions, a case study that we discussed during the roadmaps was about impact of COVID-19 to Malaysia when we were talking about pharmaceutical products. We have a lot of manufacturers, but we do not have enough supply of ingredients, as was mentioned just now. So this, at the same time, it is a problem, but it also creates opportunities on how can Malaysia, especially the SME, step into these new businesses. We spoke about API, or active pharmaceutical ingredients. So this is one of the many initiatives that we identified the roadmaps. There are many more, so this is how we are going to move forward from here. And in the next 3 to 4 years, as I mentioned just now, we are looking to 9 roadmaps, and we are estimating maybe annually we are going to review or look into specific 3 sectors every year in terms of these strategies.
Dato' Alim, perhaps you'd like to add something to that?
The pharma industry, especially the local, really looking forward for all these new initiatives.
Haji Roslan?
Yeah, I think we should be going according to the changing of lifestyle, the dynamics of business. This is very critical because now we are talking about changes, you know, every minute. Not every year or every 3 years. So every 6 months there are changes in lifestyle, in things we do. And when you talk about new norms, things change again. And then we have to be agile enough to change and, of course, be adaptive to the environment.
Excellent. Now, talking about government ministries and agencies, of course, we certainly require that collaboration and cooperation to be involved, especially in implementing governance in order to facilitate the implementation of all these initiatives under the roadmap. What is the current scenario like? How involved are they in coming on board to the roadmaps?
Okay, this is one of the critical subjects that we need to address in these initiatives. As you mentioned just now, we heard a lot of roadmaps, blueprints being announced by various agencies or ministries, even some of them coming from associations. So when we started this journey, the big question is that how do you make sure that your roadmap, for example, is going to be different from the rest? So one of the areas that we identify is the governance itself. So we were told that all these roadmaps, what we have achieved to date is only 10% of the work. It's on the planning part, the strategy is only 10%. The balance 90% is about the implementations. And sharing inputs or getting inputs from the various stakeholders, we establish what we call as sectoral working groups to govern the implementations. So these sectoral working groups or SWGs will be the platform to actually drive the implementations of each high impact initiatives that we have identified before. And it is also a platform for us to not just within the scope of roadmaps, but any related or new issues that is related to that particular sector can be brought to this platform for further actions. So I'm glad because the first two sectors, we have Yang Berbahagia Datuk Halim as the chairman for the SWG for Halal Pharmaceutical, and Tuan Haji Roslan as the chairman for the SWG Food Services.
All right, I'd like to bring Haji Roslan and Dato' Halim both in to sort of like share your experiences in the initiatives and the roadmap itself. Perhaps we can start with the food services sector with Haji Roslan.
Now, we have been involved with the roadmap since the focus group discussion and strategy workshop to deliberate on those challenges that we have been discussing, among others. Yeah, it's not just limited to what we have been discussing today. We are focused on looking at all areas of the food service sectors. Yeah, sourcing of ingredients, the process, the production, the introduction of technology, as well as the delivery services, which up till date have yet to be resolved in terms of the standard operating procedures, in terms of the certification requirements. Yeah. Among others, yeah, it was a great experience, and we know that to move the needle through, yeah, we need to have close collaboration between not just the regulators but other stakeholders, the public sectors, the consumers, yeah, and then we really appreciate what HDC has been doing, and that ground up initiative. I think this ground up initiative is what we are looking at. We are looking at this to be something to be, you know, included into whatever that is planned by those people in the upper hierarchy of power of governance. Yeah, so starting from raw materials, meat and meat related ingredients, right to the end user consumer, have always received this as something that is outstanding. I mean, we need to do that. Okay, then there are many recent cases that have been brought to the public attention regarding fraud of meat products, for example. There are several reported incidences. Yeah, so we need to address this together rather than in silos, because the reason why it happens, because I believe that there is no synchronization of what each agency does. So we need to look at this and improve in to ensure that the halal ecosystem is free from any flaws.
Perhaps I can get Dato' Halim to share on the experience for this area.
We had heated discussion.
I'm sure
during these workshops. It's not easy to talk about our weaknesses at national level, at agencies level, but we did it in a good spirit. So all in all, it was a great journey to be involved in the sectoral roadmap development. The openness of HDC and other ministries and agencies who send all their reps were an excellent sign of the national commitment or pledge to resolve our challenges and grow the halal pharmaceutical industry into the future.
Right, thank you very much, Dato' Halim. Now, this brings us to just about the conclusion of our panel discussion from our eminent speakers up here. Now, in conclusion, I'd like to invite our speakers to individually share with us, just very briefly, perhaps a message to the audience, what sort of call to action you'd like to have, and of course, your own personal experiences that you would like to share with them and ask them for what you would like to see in growing the whole halal industry, both in Malaysia and internationally. So perhaps very quickly we can start with Haji Roslan.
Well, as I said just now, this initiative that HDC has undertaken is a ground up initiative where you plan, where you look at things from the ground rather from upstairs or from the air. Yeah? So if it comes from the ground, you see, you engage with those that play a part in whatever that it is within the whole halal supply chain and within the halal ecosystem. However, we talk about halal, the element of traceability and integrity of whatever system, whatever products, whatever produce that we offer needs to be intact, and we cannot compromise on this, yeah, traceability and integrity. Ensure efficient control, yeah, and of course, when you talk about control, you need surveillance and monitoring. And when you talk about monitoring, today we look at the application of technology, the application of various technologies, blockchain, artificial intelligence, the Internet of Things, and also big data analytics, which can be included into our planning and to ensure that we have the upper hand in terms of getting things through. Yeah, and now we see based on our experience during the pandemic, yeah, people are getting familiarized with, you know, online sourcing of materials for them to cook in their kitchen. The same applies to the industry. They are sourcing ingredients through online, and that is happening, and this needs to be enhanced, and how we see potential into it to be promoting the growth of the halal industry. To avoid being manipulated, cheated or exposed to various misconduct and wrongdoings by those who are benefiting from such malpractices, we need to also put in place and maintain a ground for a sound surveillance, control and monitoring mechanism. Yeah. Lastly, incorporate element of sustainable development goals. This is very important because we want to ensure it does not only be sustainable to business, but it's also sustainable to environment, as well as contributing to the development of growth of nations and people.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Haji Roslan. Dato' Halim?
Imagine, if you will, Malaysia to produce the world first halal certified by JAKIM COVID-19 vaccine. Not one, but many. Wouldn't that be the game changer for our economy and a great new norm for our pharma industry? And that can be done.
Excellent. Thank you. Gianni Sofian.
Thank you. From me, I think there are 4 points that I would like to say. The first one, as we know, halal is diverse. So within halal, because you have the same target group of the consumers, if you're not in food service, you can go to actually pharmaceutical, cosmetic, skincare, things like that. There are 11 sectors. There are many opportunities within the halal industry itself. Number two, business model are changing. Previously, as we discussed briefly just now, if you're a food service operator, you used to have your mortar and bricks restaurants, something like that. Now you are changing into the food delivery systems. So we need to always be creative and be alert to the changes that is affecting our sectors. There is opportunities in every problems that we see. The third one, sectoral roadmaps is something that we have developed together. Like Haji Roslan was saying, it's from the ground level that we want to bring up. So we need a lot of support from our key stakeholders. We have engaged in that workshop. We have JAKIM, we have MITI, we have EPU, we have MOF, many industry government sectors, including the industry player themselves. So we need to look at this as one of the important initiative that we need to work together. And last but not least is value creations, because HDC vision is to make halal as the first business choice in any business ventures. It's not just for HDC, but for the nations. So in order to do that, we need to create value. We need to do something meaningful to ensure that we can achieve our aspirations to make Malaysia as the global halal hub and eventually provide that socio-economic impact in terms of trade, investment, employment, and at the same time protect the halal integrity of our products and services as well.
Thank you very much, Hani Sofian, Dato' Halim, Haji Roslan. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the end of our discussion panel on the subject of seizing opportunities in these two sectors for the halal industry. And we certainly hope that with the sharing and the insights by and the expertise provided by our panel today, that you have gained a deeper insight and you too can take advantage together with your organization, with other stakeholders, to seize the available opportunities in the halal industry for these two sectors. With that, once again, I thank our very distinguished panel speakers, and we thank you for your time. Have a good day. Well, thank you to our very distinguished panelists for a very informative and insightful session. You're all, of course, clearly experts in the practice of the halal industry, and we do appreciate your contributions in helping steer the halal industry forward. Now, ladies and gentlemen, next up, we'd like to share with you two videos that showcase a snapshot of the opportunities of the halal industry, as well as issues and interventions designed in the sectoral roadmap. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's presenting to you halal pharmaceuticals and food services sectors.
Halal market for pharmaceuticals was recorded at $87 billion in 2018 and is forecasted to reach $150 billion by 2025. In contrast, halal pharmaceuticals market size in Malaysia was only at 1.2 billion ringgit versus total market size of 9.4 billion ringgit. One of the challenges of the pharmaceutical industry is the lack of halal certified active pharmaceuticals ingredients, or API. In an effort to grow the industry, a consultative engagement was organized among key industry players and government agencies, through which five key issues were identified. Audit inconsistencies, halal ingredients, high capital, cost of compliance, high import dependency. The Halal Pharmaceuticals Roadmap consists of four key result areas. Access to marketplace. Growing halal biopharmaceutical industry. Strategic partnership. Improving certification process. Under the four key result areas, six initiatives have been identified, covering focus areas from the ingredients, production and halal vaccine, creating more local champions, and improving certification process. 21 interventions consisting of policies review, infrastructure, incentives and human capital will be required to resolve all the challenges in pharmaceuticals. Malaysia is set to be the first to introduce halal vaccine. We aim to increase the number of halal certified pharmaceutical companies. We aim for halal pharmaceuticals industry to record a revenue of 1.6 billion ringgit by 2025. Together, we will continue to strive towards strengthening halal pharmaceuticals. The Malaysian food services industry was valued at 95.3 billion ringgit in 2019, showing a compounded annual growth rate of 9.5% since 2015. In current circumstances, This is projected to grow up to 201 billion ringgit by 2025, driven by the new norm post-COVID-19 as a result of an increase in online food deliveries. Despite its growth potential, the halal food services face challenges to capitalize on the growing demand, which we have identified. Five key issues. Traceability. Know-how. Standards, awareness, enforcement. After a series of engagement, the stakeholders agreed on six key result areas. Halal ingredients segment, strengthening policies, support for SME certification, exporting food services, industry partnership, business and consumer awareness. Under the six key results areas, we have identified seven initiatives covering focus areas from the ingredients, food preparation, delivery, and even up to global expansion overseas. The implementation includes coordination with various ministries and agencies to intervention in policies, infrastructures, incentives, and human capital development through robust delivery unit and governance established by HDC. The initiative's design will benefit the food services industry, such as McDonald's Malaysia, to expand the outlet from 295 now to over 300 outlets by 2025. Food delivery companies like Food Panda and Grab Food and their business partners will be able to double its growth. We aim for the halal food services industry to record a revenue of 40 billion ringgit by 2025. Together, let's grow the halal food services industry in Malaysia.
We certainly hope that you find those videos interesting and engaging. For all stakeholders and ecosystem players, please feel free to contact HDC. The contacts are shown on your screens for further information on the key results areas or even just to discuss initiatives and interventions designed in the roadmap or simply just for support in navigating some of the challenges and issues in moving forward. Now, at this juncture, we're pleased to share with you the MOU signing between HDC and the Department of Statistics Malaysia on halal industry statistical data analysis and sharing. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good morning to distinguished guests. Yang Berbahagia, Dato Sri Dr. Muhammad Uzir Mahidin, Chief Statistician, Department of Statistics Malaysia, DOSM. Yang Berusaha Encik Hairul Arifin Sahari, Chief Executive Officer, Halal Development Corporation, HDC. Puan Nazaria Baharudin, Deputy Chief Statistician, Malaysia, and Encik Hani Sofian alias Vice President, Industry Development, HDC. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome all to the Memorandum of Understanding signing ceremony between Halal Development Corporation, HDC, and the Department of Statistics, Malaysia, DOSM. Allow me first to give some context to this MOU. The MOU is to officiate HDC's collaboration in developing the halal economic statistics for the joint working committee between HDC and DOSM. A series of workshops had been conducted in Q4 last year to establish meaningful, trusted metrics to measure the progress of the halal industry at a national level, with the aim, of course, to develop a robust key halal economic statistics or indicators, specifically halal gross domestic product, halal trade, and employment. Ladies and gentlemen, let us now witness the signing of this MOU between HDC and DOSM. there we have it. The documents have been signed, and signed also by our witnesses. I now invite our two signatories for the exchange of documents to signify the completion of the signing of the MOU between HTC and DOSIM. Congratulations, gentlemen. Congratulations, HTC and DOSIM. With this, ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to just about the end of our event. We'd like to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for taking the time out to join all of us and learn more about the Halal Sectoral Roadmap 2021 to 2025. We certainly look forward to you being a part of the realization of this roadmap. Along the way, HTC will be sharing further progress of the roadmap implementation in the next few years. We'll also be sharing with you a link for a short feedback form for our event today. So make sure you do take a few minutes to share your thoughts with us. Thank you once again to all of you for joining us. Let's together seize and realize the opportunities in these two key halal sectors.